Yes, people, what's going on? It's your boy Theo here, and this is a real talk. Now, yes, my beard has gone and I got a new haircut to match. This is bigger than that. I'm here to talk about what happened at the Oscars last night. I know I'm late. I had a very busy day and I was trying to see how I was going to fit in time to do my video, and now I'm here doing it. So here we go, my reaction to it. I woke up this morning and I just wanted to, see the headlines as I normally do. And I was shocked to see what transpired last night at the Oscars. You see, Chris Rock, right, made a joke about Will Smith's wife, Jada, who has alopecia, and called her G.I. Jane. Now, I know that Jada Pinkett has starred in G.I. Jane, in which she shed her hair for the role, but that was back then. Years later, fast forward, she's got alopecia, and she's spoken about it openly. I'm aware of that. She has spoken about it, and I've heard and read what she had to say, and it's terrible. And I can understand what she goes through, because when you're going through something that affects you, it's brave to talk about. I mean, there's health problems going on with me. For example, I suffer from eczema. I've been suffering it now for well on over 25 years, something like that. I've had to endure a lot. I even went to hospital for a week because of it. I manage it better now. The one thing I can't do is actually have tattoos. Well, I could have tattoos, but I'm just very, very conscious about my skin. Like, this is why I don't tend to let things stress me out so much, because it will trigger it. So I don't like to kind of stress about a lot about things. So that's been it for me. And also, I'm actually half deaf. Not many people know about that, but I am actually half deaf. I'm deaf in my left ear, I've been deaf since ever since I can remember. I claim no benefits, nothing. I've continued my life as normally as I could possibly can. That's just been me in a nutshell. But back to Jada Pinkett Smith, right? When I saw the reaction, I knew that she was not finding it funny at all. I didn't find the joke funny at all. And normally, when I love comedy. I love comedy when I know it's really, really funny. But when you're having a joke and it's not going over, that's when you kind of think to yourself, well, you make yourself a little bit more uncomfortable. I've heard about a lot of people's opinions about this whole thing, and the way I see it is that yes, Will could have actually used words. Will did lose his cool. Was he out to protect his woman's honor? Yes. Obviously, the first time in which the Oscars were going ahead because of the pandemic, it was supposed to be something beautiful. It was supposed to be something that's nice. It was supposed to be something that, should be celebrating film and, what's the pandemic done to it all, and what's going to be the change from it, and how they're going to work, and how they're all going to put things together. It's difficult. It's difficult as it is. It takes over 1,000 people to make just one film. And it's never easy. It's never easy because of luck that goes on set and everything else. So I can understand. And I've been hearing about other people, celebrities, giving their opinions about it, and they talk about their fame and, how it makes them feel about certain things. And I can understand to a degree of where they're coming from. I mean, I, of course, I'm not famous. I'm not even close to being famous. But if I was ever famous, I've said this over time, I want to try and live as normally as I can possibly can. Just because of the fact that, I know where I come from, I know who I am as a person, and I want to be as staying true to myself as I can possibly be. I don't want to get myself into the limelight, not into the limelight, but I don't want to fall into the whole trap of, separating myself from the reality. I want to try and stay within reality, if that makes any sense. What's going to be the fallout from this? Now, I heard that Diddy has facilitated a meeting between Chris Rock and Will Smith. I don't know what's the status of it. Diddy said that it's all sorted and everything else. Another publication has come out and said that no, it's not the case. Nothing's been sorted. There's even talk of Will Smith possibly getting his Oscar being revoked. I don't think that's going to happen because Will Smith has worked for so long. I've even read his book, and yeah, I can understand that he, with his career, he's done work for wealth himself because he worked hard. He likes music, but he loves acting, and he wants to perform. He wants to be able to do his best to give a show to everybody, whether it's on the mic or on film. That's who he is. Chris Rock obviously is different from that. Obviously he did well as a comedian, and then he's trying to then he done things of acting, and then he done things behind the scenes of it all. And I respect them both. I respect them both as men. I respect them both for what they've done in terms of the showbiz. And yeah, it wasn't a good look. There's no winners here. Chris Rock shouldn't have not made that joke. He could have joked about something else. And he could have joked about something that could have been out there and everything else. And I didn't expect that to happen. And I just feel like, why should it happen? We didn't need to see it. Will Smith could have dealt with this better. Obviously, in his speech, I listened closely to what he was saying, and tears came down his face, and he was talking about how he was being conducting himself throughout his career and his life. Obviously, we know the relationship that he has with Jada. It's very. I can't even explain what his relationship is, but I'm not going to say a lot about it because we all know what the status is with that. But I can see that there is care there, and I know that there's love there. But I don't know what they're like now. I don't know how good it is or whatever. I don't know. There's not a lot I don't know, and I won't say on what I don't know. That's why how I run my channel. So yeah. Yeah, it's just been tough. It's been tough, and I think now is the time in which we shouldn't be able to, punish somebody for how they feel, or in the heat of that moment. The police are not going to get involved. Chris Rock is not going to press charges. Chris Rock didn't expect that coming, but. We shouldn't have. He should have known better at that stage. The Oscars is going to be remembered. This year's Oscars is going to be remembered for quite some time, for years to come, I think, for just this moment. It's not because it's completely overshadowed. Interesting people who have won things. Kenneth Branagh for Belfast, for example. It's completely overshadowed everything, and you saw everybody in terms of the celebrities getting interviewed, and they've been asked about the situation, how they felt in that moment and everything else, and what did they think and everything, and they're reluctant to try and say anything. It was just crazy, and they've been put in a tight spot, and all I can just hope for is that this situation just needs to end, comes to a swift end sooner rather than later, because you know there's bigger and better things to worry about. Obviously we've got the war going on in Ukraine, that's dominating it now right now. There's so much that's going on, and I don't think we need to keep talking about this and talking about this forever. This is one moment that should have not happened. It's making news for all kinds of the wrong reasons, and like I said, I got respect for both men, and I just hope that they can just bury the hatchet and just keep it moving. And yeah, that's my take on it. I know it's been long. Sorry if I took up most of your time, but I just wanted to air out a couple of things and just be able to say what I needed to say. So if you like this video, please like it, subscribe if you're new, comment below, let me know what you think about the situation, and I'll be back with another video soon. And yeah, I'll be back with another video. Peace out, people. Thanks for watching.